Recording in progress.
Reminds me of that class you had.
All righty. So, Frankie, you were telling us about the tea with your love life. What's going on with you? How's the DMV dating scene? Are you dating? Are you taken? What's going on?
But before I hop into that, just like being in the DMV is like totally different than being in Pittsburgh. Like the men that are available, the men that you attract, the conversations you have, totally different. Like it just has more substance. Like for instance, somebody asked me, they're like, "Oh, how did your wax go today?" I was like, it was great. It's normal. And then they're like, "Is it better than the wax center in Pittsburgh?" I said, honestly, everything in the DMV is better than in Pittsburgh. The men, the food, the energy, the atmosphere, the people, like everything is just totally different. And I'm saying that to say, like, just the men that I have met, even though they may not have been for me or somebody that I continue to date, I still gain something from having a conversation with them. It's like a conversation about your success and you growing here and like connecting you to people that can help you grow. So that's been beneficial to me. Right now, no, I'm not taken. I'm single. I'm dating.
No, that's right.
I'm more of a like person of monogamy, so like I like to talk to one person at a time. I don't like to talk to a whole bunch of people. That's just not my thing. I don't feel if I'm talking to a whole bunch of people, then I must not care.
What really you
about
trying to say?
Any of you. This is a pain in my time. I can't multitask. I'm not going to multitask. So right now, I'm talking to one person. I'm really only interested in that one person. But I still am open to talking to other people. That makes sense
for sure. I think it's part of dating. Like you're trying to get to know somebody, trying to decide, you know, just how you feel about them. I think that's totally fair. And I feel you with the one person at a time. I think it's just easier.
It's like, yeah, I'm not sitting on that one and that one and hanging out with this one and that one and being blown out by this one and that one, just one at a time. One at a time.
Yeah.
We got time for, I just can't, you can't keep up. I'm keeping up. Yeah. You gotta go get tested in between. I'm not doing that. No, one day at a time.
Too much work. I feel you. Thank you for sharing those updates. So you found the DMV to be a better dating pool than Pittsburgh.
Yes. And there's probably other cities that are even better dating pools, but like right now, this is the best that I've gotten thus far.
Okay. That makes sense. I mean, you figure, I feel like Pittsburgh is, it's like a major city, but it's such a small major city, right?
Yeah.
And there's not a lot, in my opinion, of industries in Pittsburgh. Like, they either work at UPMC, they work at a bank, they work, you know what I mean? Like, there's not a lot of diversity there, right? Like, when you're thinking about the DMV, you're getting everything. You're getting artists, you're getting politicians, you're getting, you know, like, just, you're getting educators. Like, and granted, those things exist in Pittsburgh, but I do think it's more secular in the DMV. It seems like it's just a more diverse pool, just a bigger community, especially when it comes to Black people and Black people. Who, you know,
totally.
Yeah, it's a different... It's a different community of people.
Like Pittsburgh,
other, but they're just different.
No, I agree. Like Pittsburgh does not advertise like diversity. They don't talk about like that being their mission at most. You know, most companies, they have missions like our mission is to do this and this and that for the community. Like a lot of the places out here, companies, any other kind of business, corporations, they talk about diversity being very important to them. And a lot of places don't do that. So I lost my train of thought, but they advocate for diversity. Pittsburgh does not advocate for diversity. That is just white and racist and old and just not it for a young African American woman.
So would you say the culture like is more celebrated in the DMV than in Pittsburgh?
Oh yeah. It's totally different. They trying to not only diversify with African Americans, but it's like Ethiopians, it's Hispanics, it's Indians, it's the white people that bring.
She love her some Indian men, y'all. Any Indian men listen? Slide in the DM.
I date one Indian man, and now I just love them all. Not true. That's just like you date one Black man, you love them all. Not true. They different. But yeah, they bring about diversity every kind of way, and that's why I love it here. There's a lot of Africans here too.
I believe it.
Sure. No, there are, especially in the club.
Yeah. That's fair.
Yeah. Loving it.
Okay, I see you. Well, you're gonna be our like eyes and ears out in these streets and from like a younger perspective.
I'm
pushing 30 this year. I'm in a new
You don't look 30 at all, babe. You still look 25.
Yeah. I literally told my mom, I called her like last week. I was like, bro, I'm about to start using night cream. That's like I'm about to make it to that age where like I gotta be prevented. Because if you know my mom, you know she's a baddie. Like she's bomb.
She is.
She's beautiful. That's a lot of pressure to be your daughter, your only daughter. There's not somebody I can share the pressure with. You know, I don't have another sister.
Your brothers.
It's just me. And my brothers, you know, niggas can look ugly as hell at any age. We still need one. So my brother, you know, there's no pressure. But I was like, damn, I like being your daughter right now. Like, I feel like you look like sisters. I mean, we about 20 years apart. So, like, I ain't, you know, I ain't fucking with that. Like, I ain't look a lot younger than you. So I'm like, all right, I'm about to start collagen it up, night creaming it up. I don't know. I got to figure out a routine.
Going to that section in Walmart. Right.
Yeah.
You look fine. It's all in your labels. Head.
right. Gotta put my glasses on to read shit. It's like,
right? I was like, shit's changing. I don't know. Boy,
y'all trying to grow up fast. Y'all ain't hit them points yet.
Well, I gotta
you put my glasses. You be surprised when different stuff is knocking at your door, it changes your mindset.
Ooh.
Like, when you're 25, like, you're like, oh, I'm on a downslope. You know,
next
like,
it's year,
like,
this year. Just,
wait till you shit yourself.
You don't talk about the wrong shit on the podcast. You know that? No pun. Wrong shit.
You said no pun. Hey,
all everybody's used to be in my mouth.
That's fine. You can spill your shit. Don't spill nobody else's.
Who shit themselves on this podcast? Me. But that's another story for another time.
That's definitely a story. We need to know.
After you give birth, your body start doing a lot of weird shit. No pun.
Oh, that's fair. That's
not ready for that.
When it comes to shooting yourself from birth, it's a very sensitive topic in this
house. Exactly. And I shit myself after birth.
It's not sensitive to her.
Your body's changing. Shit's loose. And you got to...
Everything is just loose. Yeah, there ain't nothing here, but I don't want nothing to get no loose.
Everything loosens up, baby.
Right and tight.
just
for as long as it can. Come on, no,
hold on to that shit.
Because the mother nature kicks in, it can be a beast.
No, I was telling her yesterday, I was like, you give birth to a baby, your vagina go... Like it'd be
that's it, how they get out.
Yeah. Well, what you drinking?
Oh, it's just juice.
Something special, daddy.
This is Sam's Club juice. Zuri, we're walking out. Zuri goes, mommy, I want pizza. I was like,
a pizza.
First of all, the fact that you know how to ask for pizza. And then we're at Sam's Club, like she knew where we are. Right? Like, there's so much that had to go on that moment. I was like,
she's like, and they just got the receipt. I
got to
ask right now.
She was. Yep. She was walking right past it. She was like, mommy,
pizza. Turned around and got it for
you. I sure did. Yep. I sure did. And then the girl was like, do you want a drink with that? I was like, is it free?
Is it a condo?
She was like, yeah, it's the same price. I was like, why didn't you say that then?
Right.
Give me my cup. It's free. Right. Right.
Now I remember back then, your parents used to buy them big ass pizzas from Sam's Club for parties.
No.
Did y'all parents shop at Sam's Club and Costco growing up? Because my mom did okay, my mom did.
So
she led the Giant Eagle. My mom,
but we were
Giant
still
Eagle
on people's membership.
I like that. Listen, first of all,
you gotta add that in.
They get their money regardless. You know, if your mom paid for it, but your sister or your auntie use it, that's where you're getting her money.
Technically,
you can have two people on the membership, so you could have. No. Who's to say you don't live with your auntie? It's two households.
You just take the cards and go. Take a picture of it. Yo, let me borrow your membership. They
just
don't
say that. Just say that. You say that y'all steal it. It does not.
Everybody do that. They know everybody do that for Sam's Club.
People still say memberships, everything.
We just share it. Sharing is caring. That's all we do.
Sharing is caring.
We're not stealing. Sharing and stealing.
We're not stealing. Yeah, they're sharing and stealing, and we're not going to blur those lines.
Okay.
Right. Y'all do realize this is being released on the internet. We are being watched. Surveillance. Watch what you say.
I know what's going on in my life.
They're not talking about anything new. They know good and well that who's using that card right now, Sam's Club, don't match a membership name. because the credit card went through and was approved, honey. They got their money. That's all they care about.
Right. As long as y'all just got paid,
you're right.
You have never seen an ad like, oh, come get a membership. They don't got commercials. They good.
They don't.
Oh, we got, we don't have Sam's on here. We got blowjobs, BJ's. It's called BJ's Wholesale. We don't have
Sam's. Y'all can tell the people that need dick and the people that get dick.
No, it's, that's our Sam's Club.
It's called BJ's.
BJ's, I don't know what it stands for.
Down here is like a restaurant, like Chili's.
Yes, we do have a BJ's restaurant too.
Yeah, we have that.
I don't know what it stands for.
I'm seeing
it's wholesale something.
Benjamin John, I don't fucking know.
Probably Sam, yeah, probably white nigga that
like Sam Club adjacent.
What did you say?
What's it stand for?
I don't know what it stands
for. We gotta dive more into some more what I love at content. I feel like we're getting into lifestyle content, which is cool.
But we're not a lifestyle. But
people didn't come here to talk about Costco. Okay.
They wasn't trying to talk about BJ's story.
Well, I said BJ's.
They weren't. But you know, Jay did a plug. She said BJ's are for blowjobs.
Thank you. Come on,
people. There's roll nothing with on. Me. I'm rolling.
Sometimes you just gotta vibe.
Sometimes I gotta be room and be like, calm down.
They miss my freak ass. Y'all know it.
They do. They want to know what's going on with you. They
sure do.
That's why we had to come back because they want to know what's going on.
I need her to spice up her life then if they want to hear what's going on because this bitch ain't been doing shit.
Into the juice. All right, let's roll.
I'm ready. Yeah. I'm ready. Shit. I'm tired of my
spice up my life. Bitch, all them seasons in the cabinet. Spice up my fucking life. You still trying to
see this? I know it's good.
Oh, I'm gonna send you a picture when we're done, girl. We be cooking. All right, let's get sex.
Okay. So where do we want to start? We're talking about DM. So y'all technically both are DMV dating.
Yes.
So have we met anybody?
These are the worst dates that I have.
I fucked my neighbor.
That's cool. So, was it due to looks or proximity? I need to know. Because sometimes you want convenience. That's why we go to Costco.
It was convenient. It was like a deal. You get your car detailed, and then you get some dick on the side. So, I was like, why not? It was the whole package.
Okay,
cool. It was just for a short amount of time. And he, you know, he moved away. But it was nice. He had a nice size. You knew he was working out. Like, he was, I miss that dick. I miss you.
Neighbor, wherever you are, neighbor, she misses you.
No, not really. He was an ass, but it was a nice bonus.
It's hard to find both. It's hard to find.
Yeah, he literally lived like, it was just all I had to do was truck my little happy ass down to the garage. It was nice.
You back already? Yeah, you only down the street.
Yeah, he came a little quick. But
So how did that start? How did we start talking to and sleeping with our neighbor?
No, don't look at me.
My sister.
Right.
I was like, oh, he's kind of cute. Then I was like, I don't know. And then she went down, got his Instagram. And then, like, I would drive, you know, you drive past, say hello, whatever. Then
she would have her ghetto moments when we're driving past. You know, it's springtime, the windows down. He lives right there. So she would be like, we drive up. Hi, Jonathan.
Why do you say his name?
It's a common name. It's really common.
That could be anybody.
It could literally be. I don't know who he is. If you follow him on Instagram right now, unfollow him because now we'll be able to find him.
No, so you won't.
We could have just rolled with that, and that could have been just a name I was throwing out. You know why he said his name? His name could have been Marcus.
Honestly, his name was Neighbor from the story.
Right, Neighbor. Anyway, she was like, "Hey." And she'd wave out the window every time we came home and he was outside. She'd be like, is he outside? And
she was tweaking.
Y'all are some hoes.
First of all, we have all met that guy who we tweak over. You ain't the first tweaker.
He might not
I tweaked hard over Dwayne. Like that story. I tweaked Dwayne hard as. And I will claim it. I'll admit it. I shot my shot. He was talking to somebody else. I did not care.
We were incredible bags.
I was. So ain't nothing wrong with tweaking. Sometimes you tweak it, man. You fuck around, get married, have babies. I don't know.
Right. You tweak so hard, you got a blood.
Sometimes you got to tweet. I mean, listen, I was at a small ass school. There was like five niggas. I knew half the niggas. Half the niggas was my brothers. So what was one left?
Right. There was not a lot to choose from up at that school, but that, ooh, never mind. We are not bringing that up.
Yeah, that's a, we'll go back into college dating a different day. That's a whole other episode. Yeah.
I wasn't really, it was more than dick, y'all, for real. It wasn't
even. You hadn't had it yet.
That's usually what happens. That's usually what happens. Sometimes they just know what they're doing. And it's hard to find both, a good man and a good dick. It's usually separate households. You know,
that's
it's
it.
Not separate households.
Yeah,
no.
I fucked my neighbor. I fucked a childhood friend. I was safe, y'all, I promise.
The childhood friend, that could be safe.
Right.
He's still a DMV dating story.
But he lives in a DMV now. And he's from Pittsburgh.
Oh.
He fucked a couple people that knew him back home.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're not allowing this, like, divorce limbo area to, like, knock you off.
No, she fucked some people.
Oh, I'm fucking all right.
Good for you.
I ain't fucking a little. I'm taking a break now, but I was fucking. I don't know if that was a man or what.
I think it's healthy. I don't think you should, you know, I feel like if it's consensual, then it's fun.
If you try to fuck, slide my DM. Just playing.
Please don't. You were fucking. You missing some stuff.
Oh, I know. I got some horrible sex, but I'm trying to go with the flow. I got some horrible
She asked you about your DMV dating.
I did. So you should, okay. I mean, so you can as much as you want. I obviously.
Right. Forget about the neighbor story. Okay. That ain't juicy.
But I don't want to take up as much.
I thought the neighbor story was pretty good, though. I thought a lot of people, I mean, I don't know. I've never fucked my neighbor. I'm curious. Important. It do sound important, though. It's a good ass thought.
I have plenty more stories, but
did
this
you
is not.
Get my mail?
But this is not the Jada podcast, so I need to spread the love everywhere.
You just don't want to talk about it today. That's
fine. Oh, what? You're talking about 23's ass?
23 or.
Shit.
23?
Or.
I fucked a 23-year-old, y'all.
For context, folks, she's 28.
Oh
yeah, I was about
sorry.
To say. Yeah.
Oh my God. So she acts like she's 21, and she's like, "I'm like, okay, for sorry. Context,
I'm 29 years younger."
Yeah,
that sounds real bad.
Like, we know you're not 35.
You just turned 29. Unless it's happened like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah,
you were 28.
She was 28,
folks.
What story y'all want to hear?
Which one?
I want to hear all of it. This is about the DMV dating. Y'all have to catch us up. We've been gone for a year. Our people want to know, what have y'all been doing? I've literally breastfed until my daughter was 12, and then I went doing. That's me caught up.
You still got some interesting things to do.
Okay. So, since I got to take my glasses off. So, I had matched with somebody on Tinder. No.
Okay.
Hinge. And he seemed, you know, pretty successful, doing well, blah, 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 blah. So then we were like texting, conversation was great. Hopefully he never watches this because it's not about to be good. so like things were cool. We would FaceTime. It was a vibe. I was like, we're just going to go. I kind of like him. So we go on a date at some like a taco spot, whatever. We're getting drinks. Well, I walk to the table and I was like, okay, that's him. And then, like, I get closer, and I'm like, what is that smell? But, you know, you be in a bar, it'd be, like, wet napkins and shit, and it'd just be all these body odors in the bar. So I thought, I was just like, oh, it's just, you know. We sit down. I was like, damn, that smell kind of traveling to the table. What the fuck's going on? And I'm in my mind. I'm sitting there, okay, we're ordering. Like, this guy has breath. Ain't no fucking way. I was like, well, just maybe, you know. So then I'm like, maybe when he gets something to drink, it'll go away. Smell that worse. I was like, fuck, he must not have done that.
Damn.
So then I go to the bathroom. I think we were about to leave or something like that. And I was chewing gum. And I was like, oh, you want some gum? Are you trying to offer me some gum? Like my breath sting. And I'm like, it didn't take it. But I didn't say that part.
Oh, you
so then
it.
I was like, okay, you know, sometimes we all have bad breath days. It's okay. So we go on another date at some spot in Alexandria. We're like eating. And I'm like, that same smell that followed us to this restaurant. So I'm like, oh, it gotta be him. It gotta fucking be him. So we're sitting there talking. It was just that, like, the halitosis. Like, it was just real, like, his teeth. I was like, ain't no way. So then I'm like, okay, three times is a charm, all right? The second time.
No.
So Francesca.
The first time, I don't, that's it.
Yeah.
It
gets you worse. Can't kiss somebody with stink.
You
breath.
Can't.
You can't kiss my neck. You can't sure. touch
me. Wait till we get there.
I know.
Okay, so we
third date. So
no, this ain't even third. Me and Francesca decided to go to Arlington where she meets this white man. Go ahead. Fill that part in. Fill that fucking part in, and then it'll end with my story. DMV dating.
Now you mean a white man.
I can't fucking stand her. This is not about me right now. Anyway, okay, that's what we're talking about. She's fine.
But it's a part of the story. Go ahead.
So we went to this, we liked going to this Asian, it's like, it's a restaurant slash at night, it gets wild and like little bars.
You gotta come,
it's
nice. So good.
We'll have to take you, it's nice.
It's like a lounge type?
Kind of, they have like an outside area, you can like
play music,
eat wings, and they have like rice and General Tso's chicken and good like drink. It's so good.
It's just good energy. Okay. People watch all the drunk people that's around Arlington.
Oh, that's cool.
There's music, like it's a cool vibe. Okay. If you just want to go out and look cute and just eat something and just be entertained by the energy, that's kind of place. So we went there. Where did we go before that? Because I was already drunk.
Don't remember what.
No, I didn't get drunk there. We went to those two rooftop places.
We did.
Okay,
we
was
fucked up.
Okay, so the reason why I don't celebrate is because I got a good score on my practice MCAT, which we'll talk about that stuff later.
Oh, congratulations.
So I was all excited. Bitch, no, not in med school.
I mean, listen, that's indicative of what you're capable of doing, though.
Yes.
We're going to always celebrate. We're going to always celebrate.
Damn.
We're going to just get over that. Like, you didn't do that. That's really amazing.
Thank you. Still working on that. Take the love.
Working on me.
Okay.
So we got drunk and we went to two rooftop bars and
we got hungry or something.
Oh, okay. So these guys started like 5 drinks and shots at the rooftop bar when we started getting drunk. But we didn't think that they were cute. So we just slid on out of there and went
like
to
that.
Bao Bao. So we're already drunk. We're at Bao Bao. And he's not white. He was Croatian. And I guess the international men just love me. It's like I'm an international.
They love her.
Right? I don't know. So
you're like a magnet.
He came up and started talking to us. I think he was a police officer.
I don't think he was, but...
Or detective.
I don't know. I was like, this is old ass dad's like LAPD.
So he's like an actor. Like he's a cop.
Yeah, like he was giving me real actor vibes.
Okay. He's on Law and Order. Okay.
Yeah.
Ooh, why am I watching that today?
Like I said, I'm not thinking right, a little drunk. So he's probably about 40.
He's old as our dad.
He was not as old as dad.
She said 40.
40. I get 40. He's probably 40.
As soon as you say he's about shit changed.
Anyway, so we were talking. He was buying his drinks. This is really not irrelevant. He smoked cigarettes. He got a kiss. And then we're going to move on.
Did you hear that bullshit? He was smoking squares. That's what those people call it. Squares. It's squares.
She
kissed this motherfucker with cigarette. He, oof. Anyway, I was
drunk.
You kissed him? First time. Now you walking around with your mouth. Okay, it gets worse. So then we're there. And I'm like, we're eating or stuff. The guys, he just don't leave. So I'm sitting there like, oh, I want some D-I-C-K.
When you're drunk.
Yeah.
So I text, oh boy. And I was like, 3 times is a charm. Like, it's going to be great. So mind you, so he picks us up. He drops Francesca off. So then we drive to his place in D.C. I'm torn up. So we go, nice place. Like, nice, clean, everything like that.
Nice car,
everything. So then, I basically told him I wanted dick. I say what I want. I don't have to have shit. So then, So then we start the interaction. I'm trying to remember. He whips it out, y'all. I lied to you not. I was like, you gotta be fucking kidding. So he starts, before he whips it out, let me go back. He like starts kissing me. Here we go. You know that smell from the first restaurant, travel to the bedroom. And I was just like, I said it can't be. But you know how, so it's like, I'm stanking. Like, and I'm not stanking because of me. I had, I'm clean. I was like, no way. Please, God, please. How do I get the fuck up out of this? And I clicked out. It was still consensual. But
now,
I felt,
at this point, can you even call God? Because God tried to tell you twice.
No, he told my dumb ass not to do it.
He said, you did.
He puts it in there, y'all. And y'all know what I mean by it. My tampons are bigger. I was like. And unfortunately, I happened to put that little gummy worm in my mouth. And I'm like, is that all you got? I don't call myself a deep throat. Y'all remember me. I don't like, I can suck some mean dick. Don't get me wrong, okay? But I don't like, I'm not a deep throater. So if you're looking for a deep throater, I'm not on your menu, okay? So he puts this shit in my mouth, y'all. I can put the dick in my mouth, the balls, even part of his leg. It was so small. Pull it together. It was so small. I was like,
"You gotta go home. This is not where God wants you to
go." Oh, I go home, all right. So then I fall asleep.
You gotta go.
It gets worse. Not really, but it does. So I fall asleep. I roll over, roll up in this fucking blanket. Like, I just want to go home. I want to go home. The next morning, I go into the bathroom. He got like a towel laid out. Anytime a nigga got a towel laid out for you, the dick's trash. Because niggas with good dick will leave you here. They ain't gonna ask you for water. Water. You want like, oh, I got a towel for your face. Like, if I don't have to go to work, I wish we could do this again. I'm like, So I'm over here like I'm sick. I get home. I lie to you. I'm like, Francesca, she's my own bitch.
I was so excited. I was sitting up in my bed like, yes, the tea, because I ain't getting no dick.
Yeah, right, tell me about it.
So I basically told her it was horrible.
Horrible. You're joking. You're playing.
Horrible.
You're playing.
So then I text them like, you know what? This just isn't for me.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I got to work on me. That's my favorite line. I mean, but I can really work on me. So if you got to work it on me, text me.
Yeah, I got to work on me.
He was devastated. He was just like, I couldn't do it. And I cut him off. Like, my cutoff game is stronger than my deep throat game. Like, it's strong. He had to go.
Guys, they just don't have both. Either you are successful and financially stable and you have a good job and you're sweet and the dick is trash, or your dick is amazing but you're broke, you don't know what you're doing with your life, and you don't have no emotions. If you have a good dick, you don't got emotions.
Sound like my husband.
But how do you feel about that? Like, because I feel like it's hard to find it all. But I actually believe, like, I found it all. So I think it exists. But I think it's hard to find. Because I always said Dwayne always had a Mary dick. Like, I slept with him before we were married.
Mary dick?
It's a Mary dick, I'm telling you.
He probably in the back like, the
perfect size, perfect girth. Like, he knows.
That's
like,
my brother. It's
a Mary dick. Like, it's just a dick. Like, you know how you fuck somebody? You're like, oh, my God, that was too big. Like, never again. Married.
Oh yeah,
and then like, that's somebody, you're like, the gummy worm. This is nothing for me, because like, for I think most women, penetration is like not our number one way of like finishing or orgasm, yeah. Right? So we do that for them. So when it's small, not hitting the walls, like there's just no feeling. There's just like nothing there. So you have to find a Mary dick, the perfect size, the perfect girth. They know what to do with it, or they're teachable. It's just it's a really good experience.
Yes.
And I think they're out there, but how do you feel? Because I feel like sometimes, like, okay, so you meet a guy and he has the things that you're looking for. Like, he has a job, he has his own car, things that just make your life a little easier. Like, you don't gotta pick him up from work. You know, just simple shit. And nowadays you gotta think twice.
People niggas don't got you. You can't just ask, do you have a car? You have to ask what year is your car.
We're gonna get there too, but go ahead.
Okay. Okay, so see, I don't know. The year would bother me. Does the year bother you? If no, tell me why.
Bitch, if somebody said I'm about to pick you up in this 2001 Chevy, you going in that 2001 Chevy? No. Imagine he's like, babe, I want to take you to this ball. I need you to get all dressed up, look sharp as ever, put on the Louboutins. I want you looking right. And he picked you up in an 01 Chevy. I'm not going. You should have rented a car for this night. My shoes cost more than your car. No.
I rented a car.
No. So, yes, I've learned to ask about years.
But he has his own car. Maybe his priorities have shifted. Maybe he's saving for a house so he don't got a new. He didn't buy a new car. What about that?
You can't be over here like this because you was the first one. This story is yours.
All these fucking stories are mad. I can't.
Yes, you're right. Certain things are priority.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I feel like it can't be black and white. Sometimes people just be focused on other shit, you know? I don't know. How important is it? Because you think it's hella cute coming out the... Because maybe, look, example. Maybe he got the 01 Chevy, but he pays to get your nails done for this day. He pays, like, he buys you the outfit. He gets you together. His priority isn't the car, it's enjoying life in other ways.
That's fine, but
her toxic ass, like, I'll put that money in the car.
Right. She was, she was like, I'll get some of my mad ass shit. Like, I got that. Don't get yourself a new car. I'll pay. Okay, so you're saying I got me worry about a better car.
Worry about car, and I think in
this decade.
Like cars. Like I'm a big car person. Like
okay.
I'm very attracted to cars. Also, okay. My last relationship, I was very spoiled. Like he had a Range Rover. He had after the Range Rover, it was a Mercedes. After the Mercedes, it was a an Audi. He bought me my own Audi. Gave that back. Like I've been spoiled with nice cars. So to see, I'm just not used to that. I don't want to be in a. I don't want to be in an O1. I don't want to be in an O5. I don't want to be in my own 11. So I mean.
Fair enough.
I feel like your car at least gonna be on the same level as my car. Because
I have a 2011.
I'm just saying that.
That's not what we want.
At a minimum, especially if you're older than me.
Okay, so that impacts it too. So like,
yeah, if you're
be more forgiving if he was your age, but if he's like the guy, an older guy, like you should essentially have more money to afford a nicer car.
Yes, because I typically date people that are older than me. So you I would expect older than me.
You ain't Ashley. Y'all like older.
I would expect you to be a little bit more further along in life. You have a little bit more stability. That's saying a lot about you based on what you're finding, what you've been doing. That's just my mindset. What have you been doing that you're not stable enough to have a newer car? An older car comes with problems.
But think about that though. Like, what if, like, so how do you determine that? So, like, you met a nice guy at the bar. If you meet a guy at the bar, traditionally you would not know what he
calls, right?
Like, he probably Ubered, or unless you're getting a ride home, which I do not recommend. you know, you don't know. So, like, this guy, y'all are talking for like a week or two, like, you're feeling him, he's good. He comes to pick you up in an 01, you're like, oh, I'm out. Like, I'm gonna go on this date, or what is your response? Like, I want to hear what you would do, Jada, because I feel like I know, but I want to. What do you think?
Sorry, that was Charlie in the back row.
That's all right. We got kids.
Yo, what did you do first?
You want Jada to go first? Okay.
So, if I'm vibing with him, right, and like you said, I don't think he's building,
y'all.
He's building his own house. He's doing well. Like, he's prepping for something. That, like, once I get my house, then I'm getting my new car. That
well, you might not know that yet.
Right.
Because I got a little something about you. So, if you ride in an 01 and living at home, no. True story. Okay,
so at home, living with his mom. It's like living with his family, like his family.
It depends. So if he's at home living with his mom, say like we're trying to buy a house, or you know, my mom's sick. I think like when our dad was sick, I moved in to help, you know, take care of him. That's different. But if you just like, you know, I'm just, you know, chilling, couch surfing, I got to pay no bills, but I want to take you out. No, because I'm definitely bringing my credit card, because I know you're not paying and I'm not paying for you. So you want to wash some dishes or something. But so anyway,
I was like financially independent.
Yeah. I want you. So even if you're like, okay, I'm not big on cars, but I'm investing here and here. I have my own. Then maybe, but it's just like,
okay.
I don't know.
You have to have a plan. Like,
unless you live in New York. It makes sense.
But again, y'all just met him at the bar. Only been talking for like a week.
You're not going to know all this.
Your next day. Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
I'm going to go on a date.
Pulls up in the car. So you would still go on a date.
If we've been texting, we've been vibing, and you pull up in the 01 and I'm already here, let's just eat. And let's just see what happens. Because maybe your 01.
So you're still open to it.
But your nice car's at home. You know what I mean? Like, so.
True.
I'm not just going to not go on the date just because you have an 01. Right. But I'm saying I'm already triggered with a red flag. Like, why do you have a okay. Then that's leading me other questions, like, where do you live? What do you do for a living? But hopefully we've already talked about these things while we're on the date, because those are typically my first kind of questions. I want to know what you do for a living. Where, in a way, you can ask certain questions that determine somebody's financial stability. Like, I'm going to ask certain questions that will determine, like, do I even want to go on a date with you? And typically, first dates, we meet each other there. You're not picking me up. We'll just meet.
For sure.
At a place. So I'm not saying that you have to have a 2023. I just need to have a decent vehicle. And if you don't, there should be a plan as to why you don't have that. And are you working towards getting that? And if you're not working towards getting that, why are you not? And if everything makes sense and it adds up, that's cool. But I'm just saying, my first thing is not attracted to an 01 car. Sorry.
And it's fine to have a beater. Like our dad, big old house, nice cars, but our dad has a little beater. They call it the little, they just hop in the ride because they don't want to put a mouse on our car. So that makes sense. Yeah. As long as there's a little bit of explanation behind it, because I don't want to be in a car with you. You know, we broke down, something happened, your tires fall off, you know.
No, for real.
That could happen in the 01. It's true.
Right. You know, you're the only one riding.
The engine just falls off front.
Yeah, no.
Okay.
That's 2 years old. Your car is almost as old as me.
No. Name of this episode will be 01.
01, yeah.
Right.
That's what niggas are 01s.
Oh my gosh. So many of the guys who follow me and listen to this and they hear this shit. Oh the fuck well.
Y'all this is know. Based off a true story. True
this is life.
And did DMV.
Okay, I don't know how much time we got, but then you said DMV dating. Right?
Yeah, DMV dating. I want to know all about what you've been. We're catching our audience up about where we have been.
Ooh, okay. This is
I like this one.
Why do you like this one?
This guy or this episode?
This guy. He was, good question.
Everything.
He was sweet.
All right, let me tell the story.
Okay.
He had no 01.
Okay, but still. So
okay,
we went out and I think her best friend was in town. We went out, we had a good time. And y'all know I love chocolate. I love me some chocolate, man. Chocolate, man, give me a cup.
Or what?
Keep playing. Keep fucking playing. I'm going to culture. Bow. Watch out. Anyway, so we go out, and I'm like, I see this fine chocolate man. I'm like, hey. But then I'm kind of drunk. You know, you're drunk. Sometimes it's distorted. So I'm like, he's fine. And I'm like, hitting on him and stuff.
She was like, this. Oh, that's a nice, fine piece of chocolate. And we're looking around like, this shit. Who's she talking about? She goes, walks right up to this person and starts having a conversation. So then, you know, me and my best friend talk to the other guys in the group. Go ahead.
So then.
Y'all go wing women.
We wing women.
So we're talking.
Wing women.
We were.
It was cool. We exchanged numbers and then, like, we were texting and stuff. Was that our first time hanging out? I think so.
What, that night?
No, did we hang out after? We were FaceTime and stuff, and then
he would call her.
He would call me.
Good communication.
He was
all right. Fine.
He was all
right. Okay.
It would be like on and off. We would FaceTime, but me being busy. I had a couple of those during that time, I think. So then we one night he said, "Let's go get ice cream," because he knew I liked this. No. We hung out a couple times before that, but it was just like real short. So then one time he was like, let's go get ice cream because Jenny's is my favorite spot. So we go to Jenny's and he was like, well, my friend and his wife are just out celebrating. I can't remember what they were celebrating, his wife's birthday or something like that. So it was like, they got a section. So we about to be up in their lab. I was like, all right, let me tell my sister, get her clothes on. We about to roll.
I was in the bed, y'all.
Yeah, we got a section.
I was ready to go to bed.
You got the bed. Though.
Yeah, well. So I was like, yo, we going to the club. So we get back from Jenny's, put the ice cream in the freezer and stuff. And I'm like, get dressed, bitch, we going out. So we go out. It ain't no damn section. We have a dinner table. So but it was cool because they're military. So we throwing shots back. One thing about military niggas, they gonna buy some shots and they can drink.
True.
This corny ass nigga, please don't watch this episode. Couldn't die. Hold his liquor. And I'm like, if you're a nigga who can't hold liquor, you can't hold me. Okay?
Now, in what way can you hold his liquor? Tell me how you define holding a liquor.
So say if this is a shot, he's like spitting it back into the glass. Just don't drink. Just say, hey, I'm not a drinker, right?
Okay.
But I get it. He was driving. So, okay. But he just,
he's
just
responsible.
Even his walk was telling me, like, you ain't got a big dick, but I should have known. So here we go. Tequila J at it again. Once again, I want some dick. So I'm sitting here at the table, like sending him the wet emoji with the cucumber. What is it? The eggplant.
Eggplant.
So I'm like,
the cucumber.
You got a mini cucumber for
sure. So then we leave. We take my sister home. She's loving his car. I'm like, it's all right. Like, it's just, she's obsessed with cars. So we drop my sister off. I don't even have sex with this man at my house. Like, if I don't get in my house, I'm not serious about you. Maybe. So then we go around to the back parking lot where it says free parking. Right. And then, good. Thank you. So we're he should have already felt some type of way if I'm fucking in my back parking lot and not my bed. So then I'm like,
you assume you have your kid at home. You don't want to have this random nigga in your house.
Well, then who was watching her? She was at home.
That's true. I don't know. In my mind, the babysitter is
the baby. we go on the back.
we're in the free parking.
We're in the free parking. Sounds like you have protection because I'm not playing with these niggas out here. So
yeah,
he had a condom, pulled out a fucking lifestyle. Was that lifestyle? The other one pulled out a lifestyle. That's how I knew this thing was little. So he pulled out. I think he pulled out a lifestyle too. If he pulls out a lifestyle, it ain't no style. So he puts it on. So I'm trying to lay back. You know, car sex is kind of hard.
It is. It's a struggle.
This is perfect. So you know, you lay back, trying to get comfortable in the car. He inserts a penis like this into me. Not the length. It was skinny. It was like poking me. It's like an IED or whatever the little fucks they're putting in.
It's like an IED like a bomb.
The birth control, the implant, you know.
Yes, IUD. IUD.
But you know, people say be poking. Anyway, I guess. So it was like poking. I'm like, why is this poking me? Like, he fucking inserted a pencil on me. What kind of freak shit is he about? It was his man parts.
It was his penis.
Came hella quick and then just looked at me like, I've never met a woman who knows what she wants. At that moment, I said, take me home.
Drive me back to the front where the reserve parking is.
I'm over here like ready to go, and it was just bad. And then I text him, was like, I can't do this anymore. My normal pattern of behavior for wagging.
And I'm on his way home feeling all good about it. She texted him, like, you know what?
I can't do this anymore. I said, I gotta work on me. So then, like, he would text me here and there. And then here's the plot twist. 23 is close with her little shorty.
So he's still around?
No, not around me, around them.
Fair.
Can't stand you. How much time we got? Yeah, I'll make this brief.
I honestly don't know. I don't even see a timer on this bitch.
We're breaking it up anyway.
Yeah, true.
We're going to break it up.
So since you want to connect this, I wouldn't have met this person if she wouldn't have got drunk and wowed. So when I said that we were being wing women, it spiraled. So basically, she was talking to 23. I was talking to this other individual, and my best friend was talking to another individual.
What are we going
to
call him? Your friend?
He's going by individual right now.
Yeah.
It's individual.
Okay, individual.
Until further notice.
So this individual.
We're going to call him Maxie.
I think of a maxi pad.
Yeah, right out here.
Okay, we'll call it Maxie.
We'll tell you why off camera.
Okay. He's not like maxi pad.
Right. Wait, why maxi?
The shoes he wears.
Oh, got it. I just thought it was funny. Okay, so
I was just laughing.
I was just laughing with you. So we meet out that night. He's cool. He's attractive. I'm like, okay, you really float my boat. Okay. So then don't do that. So then, like, I laugh through your stories. Laugh with me. So thank you, dudes. So
you gotta make a bitch laugh first.
I'm trying to get there. I'm sorry, I don't have these little dick stories to tell.
Well, yeah, you do. Oh, Francesca. Oh, we got a lot of shit to say. Get ready, y'all. Go ahead. She got two more stories.
We got weeks of content. So we're gonna finish this story off.
We can't give them everything, do I want to.
That's fair. You talk about what you're comfortable with.
That's right.
Thanks, babe.
And we'll build off of that.
Okay. So we start texting for a while. Good conversation. That's how it starts. It always starts with a good communicator. Does that last? We'll show you what that person's really like. So he's like, he'll bring up stuff for us to do, like, hey, let's go to the African American Museum, let's meet up here, let's get drinks, let's get something to eat. And I was studying for the MCAT. So I really was not worried about nobody, no dick, no dick. I was not worried about any of that. So sure. I would just be like, I don't know, maybe we'll see. And then I think he felt like I was, you know, kind of pushing him off, but I really wasn't. I just wasn't really worried about that. So eventually, yeah. I got done with my studying early enough. He hit me up just in perfect timing and was like, do you want to go hang out? Do you want to go to Top Golf? Like, we have a couple friends who want to Top Golf. So then I was like, you know what? Why not just go? Just go have a good time, see how it is, blah, blah. So I went to Top Golf with him and his friends. It was a good time, had a couple drinks. You know, when drinks start getting in the system, it's a whole nother person. Freaky friend. So then,
alcohol, it brings out your inhibitions.
It does. And I was like, you know what? I'm in this new city. I don't have no new city dick. Like, you know, I'm a very sexual person. Like, I need dick once a week. Okay. Everybody's sex drive is different. I don't like
it. It's true.
Some people, like, if I had to go without dick for a long period of time, I could. However, if I don't have to, I would like it once a week. If not, I would like it twice a week. Like,
that's fair. You know, that's fair.
All right. Keep my energy going. So,
yeah. That's fair. That's fair.
So, Freaky Friend came out at Top Golf. And,
I love Freaky Friend. So
funny. I hope you don't watch this. I'm not going to
watch this. Watch
okay,
this
so,
shit.
So then, you know, like I told you about years of vehicles, he said that he had a Chevy Malibu. So I'm thinking, when I hear he's got a Chevy Malibu, I'm thinking it's a 2016, 2018. You're a little older than me. These are my expectations, guys. When somebody does not meet your expectations, the feeling in your heart drops. Like, it just did. So then, you know, we were leaving Top Golf. We were like, we're going to go get something to eat. So he was like, you know, just follow behind me. So he walks into my car, and I'm looking for the Chevy Malibu. I'm like,
he walks into your car?
Huh? Yeah, he walks
into
my car.
Okay, there's a lot of green flags with this man. Like, I have about six right now.
He okay. Military. So subtract two.
it took me a minute. I was like, subtract two. I'm sorry.
It was good.
Green. Okay, but there was a... Sorry, I'm not going to talk about that. We'll talk about that offline. So then... He walks me into my car, and I'm like sitting there waiting for this, you know, newer Chevy Malibu to pull up. I'm like, the only car I see at the stop sign is an old silver something.
We fell in love in the back of a cop car.
Sorry. You're doing too much. See, like you say, his vehicle looks like a cop car, which technically it does, like an old school detective. If you know what?
Oh,
First 48.
That's it. Yes.
Okay,
like
wait,
the what's that called? Like the crown? Like the crown?
Yes.
Okay.
It'll be cool if we could pop up a little icon.
Because I'm like, the new cop cars are like Ford Explorers.
Yes.
Like exactly. If a Ford Explorer pulled behind me, I'm like, oh shit.
Right.
And then you drive past, you see two kids in the back seat, you're like, you fuck.
Right.
or it's those nice Chargers. But anyway, so I'm looking for the car and still don't see it. I'm like, I'm about to just go. I mean, I know where the Friday is at. I'll meet you there. So eventually, we're driving to the Friday, and he calls me. He's like, turn your headlights on. I'm like, where is he at? So then, and then I'm like, is this car in front of me? This is not, this is the oldest Chevy Malibu I've seen in the bitch. And it's honestly not that bad, but when something doesn't meet your expectations, you're just like, you're disappointed. Yeah, I was disappointed. So then we get to the Fridays, and, you know, he pays for the meal, but in this whole thing, like, I guess I dressed in a way to get fucked, but it was really just a cute outfit. In my mind, it was really just a cute outfit. I had on these light-skinned ripped jeans, I had on these wedge heels, and then I had on, like, a simple, like, white shirt that had, like, an opening in the middle. We all know I don't have no titties. So it was up in the middle. But then I was just like, when I left the house, and I'm skipping around a little bit, I was like, you know, I'll be back probably around, like, 11 p.m., 12 a.m., she was like, you ain't coming back. You haven't gonna fuck me heels. I'll see you tomorrow morning. And we did.
You're like, no, Jada.
I was like, I'll be back. I don't fuck on the first date. That's not happening.
You my damn sister. Yes, you do.
So, the year of 2020 was betting on each other's pussies. That is a lot of what we did in 2022.
2022, yeah.
2022 was like, $20 don't come back home. $20 a day. $20 you won't fuck in again.
That's the name of the episode.
No, but bro, that's what was happening. So I was like, $20 bet I'll be back home tonight. I did not come back home tonight, y'all. We went to Fridays, had a good meal. He was like, you know, grabbing my thigh underneath the table, like just it was that fuck me energy, and it was real quick.
The vibe was on.
Yeah, the vibe was on, which it came on because at first it was just real chill, and then it was more like, okay, I'm about to rip these clothes off, and you about to get nasty.
Not at TGI.
Yeah, fucking TGI's. But okay, so eventually we left TGI Fridays. Get back to his place. His place is very nice. It's clean. I'm like, okay. So the car was a no, and the place was a yes. So that's what I mean about, you know, it doesn't turn me on.
Everybody's priorities is different.
It's different. Everybody's priorities is different, and I'll still fuck with you even if you don't have the nicest car. Yeah. So we got to his place, and like his friends were there for a little bit, and It went down after that. It was a great vibe.
You ready for the twist? Because I know we're about to end. He's from the same spot as somebody's husband on paper.
Yeah. Which is great. Yes. Yeah, so
he's from the same spot as Darius. I can say anything.
I know. But I'm like,
very wild that they.
And they know each other.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, that's crazy.
It's small world. Very small world.
It is very small world. But the military is even smaller.
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wait, how long did it take for us to figure that out?
Not long, it was once he, yeah.
Said, yeah. Where Maxie said he was from.
Yeah. How did you make that connection when he said where he's from?
When he said where he was from.
I think I had mentioned, oh, that's where Darius is from.
I know somebody from.
And then we asked, like, yeah. High school y'all went to?
Yeah, and then went to the same high school.
Oh, okay. Wow. It was crazy. Really quick.
Yeah, I was like, yeah. small ass words. You can't escape these things. She said, well, you better run.
You better run. Because I'm telling you, them Fayetteville niggas, there's some shit going on. And I want to tell y'all about next episode, how I showed my ass. I was McMahon.
She was wilding, but she had a right to wild.
I was wilding. Sad chicks swear they think they be winning. As soon as you throw that power card, that you still got benefits and shit. Then them hoes want to run like roaches.
Not red like roaches.
Don't worry.
Don't play with me.
I'm saving my other
school. I'm sweet as pie until.
Until you're not.
Until you're not.
Did you just say you was eating? No.
Who said this lady's ass? Who said that?
We're not eating ass in D&D.
Oh, no, we're not eating ass in 2023.
I will never eat ass again.
Eat ass was. That was during the pandemic. We were fun experimenting.
I tried it. I did it.
If I get married again, I'll eat my husband's ass. But I'm not eating more ass right now.
So you're still open to marriage?
Shit! Did I say
that? I heard that too, because this bitch.
Okay. Yes, I am open to it. Because
I mean, everybody's different after divorce. Like everybody, some people are like, "Oh, I want to do it again. I still believe in it." And some people are kind of like, "Did it before? Don't need it again." So I mean, that's why I guess. Yeah. So I'm just curious, like, where your stance is on that? Because that's a pretty big deal. I feel.
Think yes, I do. I want the real deal this time. Like, I know I did get married at a courthouse, and eventually, like, with him, we were going to do like a 5-year big like reception party or something. I do want to wear a dress. I do want to just to like. I do want to experience it. My dad
wants a wedding. Yeah,
I do. I want to have a wedding. Absolutely. I feel like I was not robbed of that, but I knew because of finances, it was a smarter move to go to the courthouse. It just is, and I'm like, once we buy a house and we're settled, then we can have like a nice. Like real wedding somewhere. So I think that's why I'm willing to do it again, not just for the show or the, you know, to have a real solid partnership, like somebody who can really hold me down. I know we'll talk about this more of just, I don't have to be the alpha female on everything. So I'm open to it.
Okay.
That's still on the applications. Like,
all right. Okay.
Decline them all. She's going to ask for dick picking.
We'll have to break that down more next episode because I want to know more about.
Like, yes, ma'am.
Because your perspective changes. Like when your life changes, your perspective changes.
Sure does.
So it's kind of good to like talk about that and see, you know, where your mind was before, during, and now after, right? Like to see how everything like impacted you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I think we got a lot of tea back in this first episode, ladies. We got a new co-host. We got a couple of new cities. We got some new dick. I mean, it's a lot that we're all for this episode. So first of all, I want to say welcome to Frankie. This is going to be the wildest ride of your life. So you buckle that seatbelt. You strap your ass in. And we are going to be on the craziest ride. I'm so excited to be back with you ladies to spill the tea, share the drama, get the perspectives. To our audience who is loyal and missed us, we missed you too, hoes.
Yes,
we missed y'all. It is so good to be back. We are hoping to release an episode like, what, once a week?
Once a week, once every two weeks.
We'll keep y'all posted on the schedule because we got a lot of life shit happening. We're definitely going to come back and we're going to give y'all a schedule so we're consistent because we miss y'all and we want to do this.
Yes. So,
thank you. You ladies
have love y'all.
Close out.
We love y'all. And we are so happy to be back.
Perfect. I love it. Frankie, any last words for the episode from you? Any 01 Chevys, pencil dicks, anything?
I'm just excited to talk to y'all about my life, my experiences, grow with you guys, let you guys see what we're going through. You guys can shoot back to us different topics you want us to talk about, our perspectives on that. And
yeah,
we'll grow together.
Come on a ride, baby.
Perfect. All right, ladies. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. We're going to have this episode uploaded on all the major podcast platforms.
And Pornhub.
I feel the podcast would be a good intro. You know what? There is a podcast like that. It's called Plug Talk. So my algorithm on TikTok. Okay, so there's... there was a girl talking and she was talking about how she's not an open marriage, but she shares her fiance. And I was like, this is interesting. So I clicked on her page and they had this podcast called Plug Talk and they're porn stars. They have sex with the guests. So the person will come and have a conversation with them, like we're doing right now. And then they'll all just fuck. It's crazy. Now, I've never seen it because it's on OnlyFans. I don't subscribe.
That's really cool.
Only because it's unique, right? I mean, they're porn stars. They're not wrong with it. Listen, I'm all about,
She would have the first episode. It'd be called Fucking My Neighbors.
Okay. And that's all we got for today. I love y'all. Right. Fucking My Neighbors. I'm curious what Dwayne's going to name this episode. She's going to name it something crazy.
I'm having a good time as producer. But all right, that wraps us up. I'm going to get us out of here. Thank you. We'll see you all later.
I'm back, baby. Where the love? Where the love at? I'm back, baby. Where the love? Boot it up. Turned up. Piped up. I'm back, baby. Where the